And now it is my great pleasure to introduce to you our master of ceremonies for the evening. He's a 5-time Grammy-nominated singer, the artistic director of this Center for the Performing Arts, and the founder of the Great American Songbook Initiative, Michael Feinstein.
Good evening, everybody. Welcome, welcome.
I search for phrases to sing your praises, but there aren't any magic adjectives to tell you all you are.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the 2013 Great American Songbook All-Stars! Ladies and gentlemen, thank you all for being here tonight. We are all so excited to share this experience with you. Tonight, you are going to meet 10 representatives of this music for a new generation. This music is something that is constantly touching hearts all the time, making new friends and giving people hope and joy of life that isn't possible in any other way. It's amazing what music can do. Okay, we're going to bring back our friend from Dubuque, Iowa, Miss Brittany Bowerly. Brittany. Yes, yes, here we go. There it is. So, Brittany, you are from Dubuque, Iowa.
Yes, Dubuque, Iowa.
And what made you interested in this kind of music?
Well, my music teacher actually introduced me to this competition. I wasn't quite familiar with it, but I researched it and I listened to the music and it was all so beautiful, and I decided to audition for it and kind of share this beautiful music.
And you're
that I
here.
Discovered. Yeah, I'm
mm-hmm.
here now.
And you also are a songwriter. You are writing songs, and you're a member of BMI, which is the Songwriters Society, so that means you're, in what we say in Italian, you're a Macher.
Oh, never heard that before.
That's because it's Yiddish.
Oh.
But anyway.
Yeah.
So what are you going to sing for us?
Oh, I'm going to sing I'll Be Seeing You by beautiful. Irving Cahal and Sammy Fain.
Okay. Here's Fain. Brittany Bowerly. That was really great. Next, we're going to bring back from Toledo, Ohio, Grace Whipfley. Hi, Grace. So, how's it feel to be here?
It's magical to look out and just see this is absolutely incredible.
You're going to... Let's see, you're from Toledo, but yes. You're going to Capital University.
Yes.
In Columbus,
right.
My hometown.
Yeah.
That's where I had my first failed piano lessons.
Oh, no. I'm so sorry.
I think there's a plaque there that says Michael Feinstein failed
okay.
here. No, there's no such thing.
All right.
So I assume you're majoring in music?
Yes, I'm a voice major with an emphasis in musical theater.
Fantastic. Do you have a favorite show or shows?
Oh,
I know that's a hard
gosh.
Question.
Well, Stephen Sondheim is a favorite. And I love Into the Woods.
Yes,
that's
yes,
a big
yes.
favorite of mine. I'd say Into the Woods.
Mm-hmm. I'd say that's a great choice. It's a great choice. Love to see you in it sometime. What are you going to sing for us?
I'm going to do It's Still Lovely by Cole Porter.
Sounds great to me.
Chickadee, and when I kiss you, just say to me, it's divine, dear, it's divine, dear, it's the wunderbar, it's the victory, it's develop, it's diviner, it's divine, it's the lovely.
You put in all those extra divine, 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 divine. There's a whole bunch of those. Great, great, great to hear those. We'll continue our little Ohio segment. We're going to bring back Sam Pomalis, who is from Springboro. Come up, Sam. Welcome back. Do you know a song called Sam, You Made the Pants Too Long?
No.
Because you should learn all songs of your namesake.
I should do that, shouldn't I?
You made the coat and vest fit the best. You made the lining nice and strong. But Sam, you made the pants too long.
Okay.
That will serve you well in years to come.
I'll look it up on YouTube when I get
Yeah, I don't know if you can find... I'll be curious to see if you can find a YouTube performance of that. Okay, so you've just graduated from high school. Springboro, is that near Dayton? Are you?
It's about a 15, 20-minute drive.
Okay, because I've not heard of Springboro, and I'm from Ohio, and there
yeah,
we are.
Yeah, it's about a 15-minute drive from Centerville, or I don't know if you know know that is.
Yeah, I do. Okay, so now I can place you geographically when I picture the state in my mind. I put the pin. I know where to put the pin. So you play violin, trumpet, piano, and you are a concert tubist. I assume that means you play tuba?
Yeah.
Or you do tubing.
No, I play a concert tuba, mostly in an orchestral or band setting. So I did some soloing, mostly in the orchestral setting.
That's great. And you write music, yes? What kind of music do you write?
All
kinds?
All kinds of music, whatever really touches me, I guess. I write mostly piano music, because I'm really bad with lyrics. It's all kinds, some jazz, some indie, some rocks, you know.
Wonderful. Well, yeah. I look forward to hearing you do that. I do.
But now?
No. I don't want to.
Oh, good.
He looked at me with his eyes like, now? Sure, now. Right? No. No. You're going to tell us what you're going to do, and I'll get out of your way.
All right. I'm going to sing "The Summer Knows" by Michel Legrand and by Marilyn and Alan Bergman.
Yay. Yeah. Sam from Alice, everyone.
It's time to dress for fall.
Thank you, Sam. Now Sam is going to do that again for us on the tuba. You're not? Oh, you didn't bring it. Okay, all right. Well, now we're going to bring back our junior from Miami, Florida, Melinda Rodriguez. Do you know the song Melinda?
No, I do not.
Is this a dream, Melinda? Just a mirage, so they say. See, I'm giving you all your theme songs that you'll be when you're a star. That's what they'll play when you go on stage.
Okay, I'll look
or
that
not.
Up.
Yeah, she's gonna go. Yeah, sure. Okay. So Melinda, you're going to be a senior.
Yes.
And you're very heavily involved in all kinds of music because it says here that you teach like classical and jazz and music theory to middle school. What kind of students do you teach?
I teach 6th to 8th grade middle school, because we're at 6 through 12 high school, so I teach all the middle school children.
And where did all your musical ability come from?
You know, I don't even know.
Your family musical?
No.
Not at all?
None of them.
Nope. So do you feel like you're born in the wrong family? Do you look and say, oh, this is... Because that's how I felt when I was a kid. I thought, I can't relate to these people.
No, I mean, they can all draw, and I can't... I write chicken scratch, so I mean, maybe just translated into a different art form.
Isn't that the trade-off?
Maybe.
Well, we're so glad that you discovered music and you're sharing it tonight. Thank what are you going to sing? What are you
gonna I'm going to be singing Blue Skies by Irving Berlin.
Okay. Melinda.
One, two. I want two, three, four.
Thank you, Melinda. Okay, now, a recently graduated senior from San Francisco, California, Emma Roos. Here is Emma Roos. Yeah.
Well,
there is a Emma song. Do you know an Emma song?
No, but I really want to hear it.
Well, good news and bad news. There's a song written about Emma, but the song is actually written about a horse, and it's called Whoa, Emma. That's the bad news.
Okay.
It's from an MGM movie called Texas Carnival, and it was sung by Howard Keel. So if you ever look it up, Whoa, Emma.
I will do that, yeah.
I don't know if you'd want to have that played when you come on stage, but you'll decide. That's not for me to decide. So where are you going to school? Where are you going to?
I'm going to Syracuse University.
Oh, great. And three people are happy about that. I know it's a great school, especially for music. And what kind of degree are you going to?
Musical theater.
Fantastic. Well, lovely. And you've chosen a song that's from a 60s Broadway show. Do you have an affinity for the older shows, or what kind of shows
Absolutely.
Do you like?
Well, Carousel, for sure.
Yes.
Sound of Music. I mean, these shows, I feel like I've just grown up with them.
Sure.
I recently had the opportunity, I was at a restaurant and I met Shirley Jones.
Oh.
And it was just the most amazing moment of my life. I've been watching her in movies for like, oh my gosh, Oklahoma, I can't. She was like sitting at the restaurant and the waiter like pulled me over and was like, okay, meet. And she like took my hand, and it was just oh my gosh, it was the best thing ever.
Were you lucky enough not to meet her husband?
Her husband was not there. Yeah.
That's fantastic. Well,
oh,
that's
well,
really
phew.
Great.
Okay.
Yeah, you had the great, good for you. Okay, well, tell us what you're gonna sing, and I'll get out of the way. Yeah.
All right, I will be singing "What Did I Have That I Don't Have" from "On a Clear Day You Can See Forever" by Burton Lane and Alan J. Lerner.
Yes. Emma Roos. From that. In a good way. Now from Baldwinsville, New York, we're going to bring back Julia Goodwin. Julia Goodwin. So, Julia, you're going to be a sophomore in high school?
Yes.
So how old are you?
15.
You're 15?
Yeah.
It's that old joke people are saying, I have Ty's older than that. It's the old, yeah. So, what kind of music did you grow up with? Or are you growing up with, I should ask?
Well, I listened to like more of the pop music and stuff like that, but by being in this competition, I really like learned how much I missed out on all this music, because I really didn't know anything about it at first, but now I know so much, and I'm glad I do, so.
Well, we are too, because you're fantastic.
Thank you.
And do you have any desire to write songs or do anything else with this music?
Oh yeah, definitely. It's great music.
Do you play any instruments?
Yeah, I play the piano a little bit and some guitar too.
And have you had training, musical training?
I haven't had any musical training.
Well, then I suggest you don't get any.
Well, I mean.
That's. I didn't have any, so.
My dad plays piano, and you know, YouTube now, you can learn anything off there, so.
Unfortunately,
yeah.
You can, yes. But yeah, that's good. Yeah. Well, I'm gonna get out of here. What are you gonna sing for us?
I'll be singing Feeling Good for you guys tonight, so.
Okay, well, we already are, but another hand for Julia. Julia Goodwin.
Birds flying high, it's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life, it's a new dawn.
nobody can have that many relatives. I mean, it's not possible. I mean, well, I guess it's possible, but I don't think so. So that was great, Julia. Now this very personable gentleman from Astoria, New York, please welcome back Mr. Brandon Rene Ocasio.
How you doing?
Good, good. You have a great ebullience about you. You have where does your joy for life come from? You seem to be a very happy guy.
Cartoons.
Cartoons. There's all kinds of cartoons. So which kind of cartoons? Video game kind of stuff.
Yeah.
The ones where they kill lots of people and it's cathartic. Makes you feel good. Yeah. I'm putting words in your mouth. Well, let's talk about your music. I don't want to make it. So, because you're involved in an arts school, tell us about that.
I go to LaGuardia Arts High School in New York, and thank you. And I'm a drama major there. I'm gonna be a senior next year, and I'm really excited about it.
And a lot of famous people have gone to LaGuardia, yes?
Yeah.
Do you know? Should we make up some people if you can? Did Barbara Streisand go there? No, she went to Erasmus High School, yeah.
Madonna's daughter goes there. There's a name on the tip of my tongue I can't remember.
Well, that's okay. When you think of it, just shout it out during someone else's song and roll.
Or in the middle of my song.
Yeah, okay, you can. Yeah, you can use it as subtext. So you've chosen a song that was originally sung by Frank Sinatra. Did you know much about Sinatra, or you just kind of... What do you know about that? How did you find the song? I'm less articulate than you, so please talk.
Well, back at LaGuardia, my drama teacher, one of my drama teachers was, you know, she came up to me with this competition and she said, you know, I think you can really do good in this competition. So I said, wow, thank you. I'll look into it. And I did. And, you know, I auditioned and now I'm here. But the story behind Come Fly With Me is... she gave me a list of songs to look at, and for me, it was between Come Fly With Me and Orange Colored Sky. Uh-huh. And for me, I felt like in my mind, I was like, oh, Orange Colored Sky, I'm totally doing that. But for whatever reason, I was singing Come Fly With Me around the house all the time. And my mother just turned to me one day and said, Brandon, stop looking, you found your song. Stop singing it around the house.
So it worked out well for everybody.
Yeah.
Good. Well, we're looking forward to hearing you sing it now.
Thank
Brandon
you.
Rene Ocasio.
Angels cheer, 'cause we're together, weather-wise, it's such a lovely day. Just say the words and we'll beat the birds down to Acapulco.
Well, I don't know who's going to be the first place in the vocal competition, but clearly the winner of the dancing competition is Brandon. So we have that. He has that in the bag. Now it's time to welcome back a... Well, she's graduated. She was a senior. She graduated from the Chicago High School from the Arts, obviously from Chicago. Let's welcome back Kiri Quarter. Okay. Welcome back. Tell me about your name. I'm curious about your name.
Well, originally, when I asked my dad what my name meant, he said it was from a monk chant.
Kyrie eleison.
Yeah.
Latin. It's Latin.
But, I mean, little Kyrie was just like, okay. It wasn't cool, so I was like, great.
And how do you feel about it now?
Now I think it's pretty cool. I don't know many people named Kyrie, so it sets me apart.
Yes, yes. Well, tell me about your musical background. What kind of music you've been influenced by? Are your parents musical? Where did your abilities come from? Is it in the family?
Well, my mom used to sing. She used to sing at weddings and stuff. And she was amazing, at least from what I can gather.
Never heard her sing?
I mean, I've heard her sing a couple times, but she's always like, oh no, I used to be so much better. And I'm like,
but then she gave it all
awesome.
Up to have kids, right? And she blames you or that kind of thing. That's what
I
my
hope
mom
not.
Did.
Mom, yeah. We need to talk. I hope you don't.
No, my mother says, I could have had a career. But anyway, that's not about me, though. So let's go back to you. So.
Okay.
I was just having a psychological
memory.
Moment. That's okay. Yes. Yes. Okay. Yeah, so I'll be okay.
I'm here for you.
Hug me. Oh, thank you. So you're going to pursue a degree in musical theater.
Yes.
And what kind of musicals do you desire to create and do, be a part of?
Fun ones? I don't really know how to answer that.
Okay.
Cats! Right. I really like cats, so musicals like Cats.
I don't think there's another musical like Cats, personally.
There will be once I'm done.
When you're okay, that's great. All right, what are you going to sing? What are you going to sing for us? Dogs. Midnight, not a sound from the hydrant.
Something like that.
Something like
that. I'm working
that.
Out the kinks to the lyrics.
Okay, well, that's good. That's good. See, Kiri is very, very creative, and we love that about you. Okay. So, tell us what you're going to sing.
I'm going to sing I Who Have Nothing by Lee Bernstoler.
I Who Have Nothing. Okay. Here is Kiri. I love how at the end she went, like, whoa. Wonderful, wonderful. Okay, now we're going to bring back from Clearwater, Florida. I mean, she's here, but she's originally from Clearwater, Florida. Maya Jacobson. Welcome back, Maya. What, you look like you're going to say something.
I thought you asked a question. I couldn't hear it.
You know what? I didn't, but you're probably, you may be telepathic.
Okay.
So what do you, answer what you think I was going to ask you. No, I'm just kidding.
Okay.
So, it says here that the headmaster of your school is here from Tampa.
He is.
That's wonderful
support. He's right there.
introduce him.
It's Mr. Seibel, and I appreciate it so much that you came. Thank you so much for coming.
That's pretty swell.
Really?
That's pretty swell.
He's the greatest headmaster.
So tell me about your musical background.
Well, I was lucky.
What got you here?
What got me here? I sent in a CD and got lucky. But I was lucky enough to grow up with really passionate parents about the arts. I mean, both of my parents went to NYU, and my dad was in the Broadway tour of West Side Story. And,
wow.
And my mom did a bunch of off-Broadway stuff, too. So I was, and my mom's a cantor now. For anyone who doesn't know, a cantor is, I explain it to not people who aren't Jewish, a pastor who sings. She's a certified religious leader.
My mom is a Jewish mother who kvetches.
Mine does some of that too.
And she's certified in that as well. But that's great. So it was probably inevitable that you were going to do what you did.
Yeah.
And it must be amazing because you probably have total support from your parents, like, who were encouraging you to do this. Which doesn't happen very often, right?
Sure.
Yeah, so that's great. So you're going to sing what?
I'm
going to
sing Bamir Bisushain, which is by Jacob Jacobs, Shalom Secunda, and then translated into English by Sammy Kahn and Saul Chaplin.
Gesundheit. That was great.
Thank you.
Okay, here's Maya.
Thanks.
So kiss me and say you'll understand.
Love that. Oh boy. Oh boy. Okay, our last all-star for this segment is a recent graduate of a school in Berkeley, California. And she's going to come back and give us a classic song, of course. Morgan Rose. Morgan Rose. So Morgan, you're gonna go where to school? Where are you gonna go to school?
UCLA.
Yeah. And what made you choose UCLA?
I am just in love with the amount of opportunities that it offers, and just the level of, you know, diversity, and just, I don't know, I think it's so beautiful there, and I'm so excited to just soak up as much as I can.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And what kind of music did your parents play for you when you were a little girl? I was curious where this comes from, if you came to it recently, or what kind of music you were exposed to, or
rock.
Uh-huh. I've heard of that.
Yeah, you know, yeah. Been around. And then, you know, folk, some country. I have two older brothers, so like weird indie music.
Right.
Yeah.
And somehow you've come to this.
Somehow, yeah, I don't know how that really happened.
How it happened. It seems to me it's a nice contrast for the soul to be able to have all those different kinds of music. You've chosen a very evocative and kind of a very wistful and yearning song.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us about that.
So the lyrics are Johnny Mercer, who I think is just, I think he's a genius. I think his lyrics are just so, so beautiful. And the song makes me feel like a Disney princess waiting for my prince to come.
Oh, that's very sweet.
So,
well, here is our personal princess, Morgan Rose. Ladies and gentlemen, the 2013 Songbook All-Stars. Everyone stand up. Stand up and take a bow. Well, before we have the the hard part for all of us mentors, the deliberation. We do have another song for you by a mentor who is a lady who is very important in my life and in many of our lives because she is an incredible spirit on this planet. She brings such light and love and wisdom and gives so selflessly from her heart. What she's given to these young souls is incalculable. She's amazing. And she's a 2-time Grammy winner, an Emmy winner. She's performed at the Metropolitan Opera, the Salzburg Festival, with the New York Philharmonic, the Rainbow Room, and on and on. And tonight she's going to gift us with a Gershwin song. Please welcome to the stage, Sylvia McNair. At this point, another performance coming by another one of our extraordinary, generous, talented mentors. He made his Broadway debut recently in Liza's at the Palace with Liza Minnelli, a show which won a Tony Award and was nominated for a Grammy, and he was fantastic in it. For his nightclub work, Mr. Caruso has won 6 MAC Awards, 2 Backstage Magazine Bistro Awards. He appears regularly at the Carlisle Hotel with Billy Stritch, and I love him so much, I don't care that it's at the Carlisle. What's competition? No such thing. He has just celebrated his 10th anniversary as the host of a weekly Monday night showbiz bash called Jim Caruso's Cast Party at Birdland in New York. And I'm telling you, it is the place to be in New York on a Monday night. There is no other place I'd rather be. And it is because of this man's incredible ability, his talent as a master of ceremonies, as a raconteur, as a showman, as a singer, and as a man who embraces the enormity of Broadway and its talent and brings the best out of everyone. It's a great honor to celebrate this weekend with him and to have him part of our event. Please give a warm welcome to the wonderful Jim Caruso. Michael Feinstein, thank you. The best proclivities in the business.
That was some buildup. I want to meet me.
My accountant says is constant need for coffee in a Starbucks cup. The trouble my accountant says is daily need for coffee in a Starbucks cup. I order triple grande soy with extra foam instead of a down payment on a Hamptons home.
It's coffee, that's right, I said coffee. I can't afford coffee in a Starbucks.
I would like to introduce to you our mentors tonight, who is actually also going to happily perform for us on stage. She is a beloved entertainer. All of the participants are pretty wildly crazy about having had the opportunity to work with her and learn from her because she's a natural teacher. But she's also a two-time Grammy-nominated vocalist, one of the highly touted jazz voices in the world. She has performed with Michael Bublé, with Terrence Blanchard, with Yvonne Linz. She's performed in jazz venues around the country. She's appeared on The View and The Today Show. But tonight, before she gets back to the mentoring judging position, she's going to sing for us, which is a great thrill. Please welcome the wonderful Jane Monheit. I guess I have some good news and some bad news and some good news. The good news is that our dear friend and our mentor, Sandy Patty, is becoming a grandmother for the first time. That's pretty great, isn't it? She has come here from Anderson and spent time with our finalists and mentored them beautifully. But the bad news is that she is not becoming a grandmother here. She is with her daughter in Anderson, so she couldn't be here tonight because what happened was the Lord decided that this is the day that the child is born, and Sandy had to choose whether she wanted to be here tonight or be with her daughter for her first grandchild, so we know the choice that she had to make. However, the good news is that we have an extraordinary lady who has agreed to sing in her absence, a lady who has also been a very important, wonderful, learned and kind mentor to our finalists tonight. She is the chair of the music department at the University of Indianapolis, but she made her New York debut as a soloist with the American Symphony Orchestra at Alice Tolley Hall, and she sung with many, many orchestras around the United States, and I had a great thrill listening to her at the sound check tonight, and I know that you will too, hearing her with all of our kids. So please give her and our finalists and our amazing team here tonight a warm welcome to sing a medley from The Sound of Music by Rodgers and Hammerstein. Please welcome the wonderful Kathleen Hacker.
Everybody, so great to be back here at the Palladium. I am so, so excited to be here after a year of incredible, life-changing memories and moments. And I cannot thank Michael Feinstein and the Feinstein Initiative enough for that. It's been truly amazing. So many people work behind the scenes at the initiative to make sure that the mission of keeping the music of the Great American Songbook stays alive, continues to grow. And there's three individuals in particular that I want to thank right now who I don't think this initiative could have prospered as much as it has without these people. This is Jeff McDermott, Karen Kelsey, and Chris Lewis. They work tirelessly, and they work wholeheartedly into this. It's my sincere hope that in 60, 70, 80 years, my children, my grandchildren, my great-grandchildren will all love and appreciate this music as much as we do. And I really think that that's entirely possible thanks to the Feinstein Initiative. So thank you all so much. To the contestants this year, wow. I know exactly how you're feeling right now. You have a pit in your stomach right now. Your hands are shaking, and you probably have to use the bathroom. I know. But just forget about that for a second, because no matter what the outcome is, you guys need to know that you belong here, because you're here keeping the music alive. And that's what this whole contest is all about. So congratulations to all of you, because you've already won. Thirteen months ago, I came out on the stage for the first time, and I was accompanied by Mr. Gary Walters, who is amazing. And also at the New York Regional, I was accompanied by Daryl Kojak back there, and he's also just equally as incredible. And we played a little tune by two guys from Detroit, Seymour Simons and Gerald Marks, and I think it's only fitting that I sing that for you guys right now. So thank you all so much for your support. What do you say, Gary? You ready to do this?
Sure.
All right.
Personal song about my proclivities.
You're laughing at my proclivities?
I love a piano. Ladies and gentlemen, we've reached the moment of decision, and this has been very, very difficult for all of us, because we love every one of these souls on the stage. They're all extraordinary. I'd like to bring en masse to the stage all of our mentors. Okay, are we ready? We're not going to have a drum roll, but of course we're going to start with third place. And I want to say on behalf of all the mentors, on behalf of all of us, what we saw tonight in the case of every single person on this stage was the most extraordinary growth that happened in the last 5 days. And for that, these young souls can all be truly, truly proud of what they have done, because it is no small feat to be here and to rise to this occasion. So our third place is a tie. And it's not this kind. Okay. Our third place winners are Sam Pomales and Melinda Rodriguez. Congratulations. You have to share the flowers because we didn't know this was going to happen. So, congratulations. Okay. Our second place, Kiri Corter. He just said, have your moment, Mama. That was good. You bet. Are you part Jewish? This is a very Jewish thing. They have to hug everybody and do the whole thing. Yeah, somewhere.
Very affectionate.
You're very affectionate. Yes, you're great. Okay, everybody. Our first place junior ambassador for the Great American Songbook for the next year is Julia Goodwin. Take a bow. Come on, kids. Come on, let's all take a bow. Come on up. Come on up. Come on, move forward. Let's all take a bow. Here we go. Congratulations to everybody on this stage. We love you for being with us. We'll see you next year, okay? Thank you, and God bless. Mwah!